We're going to take a look at one of the file formats supported by memoQ 2013, XLIFF doc. To do so, we'll choose Import with Options. Select the XLIFF doc file, which looks like an ordinary XLIFF file from the extension. You'll notice the default filter chosen is the ordinary XLIFF filter. We want to change that to the proper filter, which is the new XLIFF doc filter. Confirm. This XLIFF doc file contains two XML files, one of which, as we can see, has been partially completed. Let's take a look at the smaller of the two files. Okay. Here we notice a preview. XLIFF doc can contain preview information as well as some other information that we'll see shortly. Let's take a look at the other file. Okay, here we can see that it's been partly pre-translated, unfortunately, with Google Translate. When we look at the second segment, we notice that it appears to have translation memory information. And we look at the third, we see what appears to be something from a translation memory, and then also something from a terminology. Actually, this project is connected to neither a translation memory nor to a terminology. What appears to be TM and term-based information in the XLIFF doc file is actually information that was embedded in the XLIFF doc file and carried with it. So this is as if the term base were actually transferred. Okay, after your translation is completed, or if at any other stage you want to export the documents, you simply return to the translations window, and here you select any of the files that are part of that XLIFF doc file and choose one of the two export options, either export dialog or export stored path. Because both of these XML files are contained in the same XLIFF doc file, you do not have to select all of the files, in contrast, for example, to when you're exporting documents from an SDL Trotto Studio package project. Okay, let's have a look at the folder to which that file was exported. And here we see the exported XLIFF doc file with a little something added to the name to indicate the target language.